Hello students, welcome to the lab class. Today we will have the lab class, that is determination of different parameters of water using water analysis testing kit. That testing kit is of Orlab Instruments Private Limited, Hyderabad. You know about the drinking water. What is the drinking water? Drinking water that is safe to consume and generally used for cooking purpose without any adverse effect to the health. It is also known as potable water. Many of the diseases are caused due to the poor quality of water. Water containing excess salts, chemicals, microbiological contaminants, and the pH values, that most important factor also, having very low and high values of pH, that would have the adverse effect to the health. So it is very essential to monitor the quality of water before consuming it. The water testing kit that are generally used for regular water quality monitoring programs to be conducted at panchayat and block level functionaries. The details of the water source and the quality of water may be collected, and the data can be computerized and saved at panchayat level. So the data will be much useful in planning and formulating various water supply schemes, and will be useful for proper maintenance of water supply schemes. Now we will discuss how the water sample is collected. Okay. The source from where the water is collected should be in regular use. Before sampling, this source should be adequately flossed. For hand pump source, before collecting the water should be pumped and washed for at least 2 to 5 minutes to clear the dirt and turbidity. Water from the wells should be taken in the middle depth of the well. For lakes and rivers, generally where water is generally collected, that is near the offtake point, and before collecting, all the floats should be removed, and then it should be collected in clean PET bottles. And the water generally collected in clean PET bottles or polythene bags. Okay. The PET bottles capacity are generally 250 ml, and where you have to take the water sample, generally the bottle is washed 2 to 3 times, or it is rinsed 2 to 3 times with the same water. After that, water is filled in the PET bottles, leaving any air space. Then the cap is replaced, and on the cap a polythene sheet is wrapped and tied with. Then you write the sample ID on the bottle itself, the field code number and the source detail should be recorded in a separate notebook. And the testing of the water sample should be done preferably within 12 hours. Now we will discuss about the procedure of testing. Before testing, all the glassware and apparatus should be cleaned properly and washed and rinsed. And you see what are the different reagents, glasswares are generally used for water sampling. And you see the different items, glasswares, etc., reagents generally used for water quality monitoring. Say water sample itself, flask, measuring cylinder, test tubes, different reagents, distilled waters, and filter paper etc. are used for the testing purpose. Now we'll take the parameter chloride and we'll discuss about the procedure. Chlorides generally occur in natural water in widely varying concentrations. The chloride content normally increases as the mineral content increases. Surface water and mountain supplies usually are quite low in chlorides, whereas groundwaters usually have a considerable amount of chlorides in reasonable concentrations. It is not so harmful. At concentration above 200 mg per liter gives a salty taste to water, which is objectionable to many of the peoples. What are the required items for testing of chloride? The water sample itself, measuring cylinder, chloride indicator tablet, okay, chloride reagent, that is basically silver nitrate solution of 0.1 normal, and conical flask. About the testing procedure, take 10 ml measuring cylinder and you take 10 ml water sample. I have taken 10 milliliter of water sample, pour it to the flask. Now take one indicator tablet, add it to the water. To mist like this. Now you see the color is completely changed to yellow. Now this is the silver nitrate solution. You add drop wise and swirl. I am adding first drop, then swirl, until the yellow color is changed to brick red color. Okay, first drop, second drop, third drop, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, nine, ten. Likewise, now you see I have added 10 drops and swirling, and you add one drop extra, and then you see the color has already changed to nearly brick red. Add one drop again. Now you see the color is changed to brick red, and this is your result. To get the value, that means to get the chloride value in milligram per liter, you multiplied the number of drops you have applied into 20.24. So we have taken all the result you get, that is 242.88 milligram per liter. But what is the allowable limit by the BIS? BIS means, that is Bureau of Indian Standards for drinking water, that is 100 milligram per liter. But according to the result, it is excess one, that or beyond the limit. Okay, it is about the chloride. Discuss another parameter, that is total hardness of water. What is total hardness or hardness of water? It is considered to those waters that require considerable amount of soap to produce a foam or lather. The hardness of water varies considerably from place to place, and in general, surface waters are softer than the ground waters. The hardness of water is due to the contact of water with soil and rock formation mainly containing calcium and magnesium. And what are the required items? That is the measuring cylinder, EDTA solution. This is the EDTA solution. EBT tablet. This one is the EBT tablet. The full form of EBT is erychrome black tea. And what is EDTA? That is ethylene diamine tetraacetic acid. Okay. You need another reagent, that is hardness buffer solution, and in usual your conical flask. Okay. Take 10 ml of distilled water. Sample water. Okay. Pour to the conical flask. Now you have to add the hardness buffer. This is the hardness buffer, and the amount is 23 drops to the sample water. Open this one, the cap, and you add 23 drops. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. Now, this is the EBT tablet. You add one EBT tablet to the sample. Okay. Now, I have added. You see, the color is changing. If it changes to wine red, that means your hardness is present in the water. You see the color? It is wine red. Now you see, it is the EDTA standard solution. You have to add drop wise, okay, to this water sample and swirl until the color changes to blue. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. See, initial, what was the color? It was wine red. I added 30 drops of the EDTA hardness buffer solution. It is not hardness buffer, it is EDTA standard solution, whatever I have added to the water sample. Okay, now the color is changed. How it is changed to nearly blue color. When that color comes, you then go for the calculation. What is the value of hardness in milligram per liter? And the number of drops multiplied by 23.7 will give you the value of hardness due to calcium and magnesium in milligram per liter. So the value comes 30 multiplied by 23.7, that comes nearly 711 milligram per liter. According to the BIS standard, the acceptable limit, their upper limit is for drinking water 600 milligram per liter, but somehow it slightly exceeds. Okay. Now we'll discuss another parameter, that is total alkalinity of water. What is total alkalinity? It is basically the capacity of water to neutralize the acids. Natural waters may contain appreciable amount of carbonates, bicarbonates and hydroxide, etc. High alkaline waters are not usually pleasing to drink. Then what are the required items you need? The measuring cylinder, conical flask, bromocresol green methyl red tablet, or it is in abbreviated as BCGMR tablet. You see this one. And other one is your sulfuric acid solution, that is of 0.1 normal sulfuric acid solution. Now you take 10 ml of water sample, pour it to the conical flask, then you add one BCGMR indicator tablet. Now swill to mist. Now I have added the BCGMR tablet and swill, and you see what is the color now? You say bluish green. Is it clear? Now you have to add drop wise 0.1 N sulfuric acid to the sample. Okay, likewise. Two drops, let the color to change. Okay. The color, it is changed to pink. Okay, I have added 16 drops to it. Then you calculate. Now the total alkalinity in water in milligram per liter as calcium carbonate CaCO3 is equal to the total number of drops of sulfuric acid standard solution multiplied by 25.5. So I have taken 16 drops and the color was changed, multiplied by 25.5. what is the value? It is coming 408 milligram per liter. According to the BIS standard, it should be maximum of drinking water, that is 600 milligram per liter. So it is within the limit. Okay, we'll discuss another parameter, that is nitrate. Basically, nitrate represents the most completely oxidized state of nitrogen commonly found in water. Drinking waters containing excess amount of nitrate can cause blue baby disease. For this reason, a maximum concentration level in drinking water is restricted to 45 ppm by Bureau of Indian Standards. So now we'll discuss what are the required items you need to analyze the water sample. Okay, you know the measuring cylinder, test tube, this is the measuring cylinder and test tube, nitrate reagent tablet A and B, one is A, other one is B. You have to take 10 ml of water sample. Take a test tube of capacity 20 ml, having cork. Transfer the sample, water sample, to the test tube. Then add nitrate A and B tablets. Okay. A, B. Okay, then replace the cork. And shake it vigorously about 2 minutes until the tablets are completely dissolved. Now see, the tablets are completely dissolved. Let it be on the stand for 10 minutes for the complete reaction. You have to wait for 10 minutes, then you see what happens. Already 10 minutes over, it is the nitrate color comparing chart. Okay. Test the white test tube on the white portion and compare the color. It is not completely white, it is coming nearly to the second one, and that value comes to 10 to 25 milligram per liter. Okay, allowable limit by BIS standards, and it is as NO3, and NO3 and allowable limit is 45 milligram per liter. So it is within the prescribed limit. Okay. we will go for the determination of the another parameter, that is fluoride. That means what is the fluoride content in water. Basically the fluoride generally occurs in ground water naturally, and for your drinking water nearly 1 mg per liter is provided with the water to prevent the cavity of the teeth. If the fluoride content is more than 1.5 mg per liter, it is risk one for your health. It leads to fluorosis disease. So the level of acceptability as per the BIS is 1.5 mg per liter. Now you see what are the required items: the water sample itself, the fluoride reagents, and all other things like your measuring cylinder, droppers, etc. Okay. First, you have to take about exactly 4 ml of water sample using the 10 ml measuring cylinder. It is more than that. I am just taking out some water. Now you see it is exactly 4 ml and 4 into to the 20 ml measuring cylinder. Transfer it to the test tube. Okay. Fluoride reagent, add 15 drops. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Place the rubber cock. Then hold it lightly, invert it and mix it thoroughly. Let the color develop. See what is the color developed. Now place the test tube on the white portion of the fluoride color chart like this and compare the color. Okay, it is coming to this one. So the fluoride content is 1.5 to 2 mg per liter. Okay. Now it is all about the fluoride content in the water sample. So I have already demonstrated before the chloride, total alkalinity, total hardness, nitrate, and this one is the fluoride. So these all five parameters I have made the demonstration in the video. Some of the parameters are in the manual. You may go through the manual. Then when you come physically to the institute, then you may do the other parameters. Okay.